Speaking during the launch of the 16 days of activism campaign against women and girls at Parliament, which is going to run up to December 10th, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, expressed displeasure that government has still failed to popularize and implement laws in place to shield women and children from violence despite budgets allocated to relevant agencies.
And that's why you find we have always asked the ministries that we pass this kind of law. Have you popularized it? And as a minister of gender, we request that you popularize all the laws in relation to gender-based violence.
However, Among noted that the campaign should also target boys, since many of them end up on the streets as a result of gender-based violence. She encouraged the leaders to lead the campaign of sensitizing the masses.
I will expect all of you, the legislators, you are the representatives of the people. I will expect you to have created awareness in your communities. Talk to the women, talk to the men. And when we talk about gender, domestic violence, we are talking about both the girl child and the boy child. Let's not leave the boys behind.
The Minister for Gender, Labour and Social Development, Betty Amongi, noted that many girls have been forced to drop out of school and get married at an early age due to gender-based violence.
Home, that is not peaceful. A girl in that home will try as much as possible when they reach a certain age, decide to say, if I'm going to always be violated, let me run away and get married. Please, take care of those girls. Do not violate them sexually. Do not defile them. Let them have a future. Because most of the girls that will drop out of school and end up in poverty, the home is not safe for them.
The WOPA chairperson, Sarah Opendi, noted that much as the laws against gender-based violence are in place, they have failed to address the challenges of gender-based violence due to lack of implementation.
A number of actions have been taken by government, but as you all know, we still remain with the violence against women and girls still continues at the community level. We know that various legislations like the Female Genital Mutilation Act were passed. We have the Gender-Based Violence Act that was passed. We have the Anti-Trafficking in Persons Act that was passed. But despite passing these legislations, the implementation has not been as fast as we all want it to be, and as much as we also want it to be, partially because of the challenges that women and girls face at the community level. Some of these cases require legal representation. And most of these women that suffer the violence do not have resources to meet the legal costs.
Meanwhile, civil society organizations under their umbrella of Domestic Violence Act Coalition have also launched a 16 days of activism campaign against gender-based violence in Kampala under the theme, Unite Activism to End Violence Against Women and Girls. They plan to roll out activities to scale up awareness on violence and prevention.
Fulfill regional and global commitments made to uphold the dignity and rights of every citizen. Fulfillment of government's obligation on the Sustainable Development Goal number 5, aiming to achieve gender equality and empower all women and girls by ending all forms of discrimination against all women and girls everywhere.
They have also decried weak laws and policies to protect the female gender against violence and lack of government commitment to implement the existing laws.
And girls in this country remain unsafe and do not enjoy the full protection of the law because the laws and policies are not fully implemented.
According to statistics from the Uganda Bureau of Statistics of 2022, 51% of women between 15 to 45 years of age are exposed to women violence, and 55% of women are subjected to sexual-related cases. Women have called upon government to act. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.